Hello, my name is Rosaria Gracia, and I'm here to bring you some exercises to support you with your strength and flexibility. And we are also going to be doing a little bit of dancing. So anything that we are doing in the session is for you. So don't feel that you need to follow everything specifically, particularly for the dance. If something hurts, by all means, please stop. This is to help you to use your body in a better way. But if it's something that is uncomfortable or you are not sure about, stop. You can check with your doctor or nurse, and then you will feel more confident. You've got this video, you can watch it as many times as you want to, so there is no rush. Also, there is going to be a little bit of progression in some of the exercises. So if you want to do something smaller, and then you can build on that, you can do that. So really take it easy. So there is no rush. This is all for you. So the first thing that we need to consider is the space. So ensure that you've got enough room so you can spread your arms. And I'm going to go a little bit further back so you can see my feet. You can really reach out. The second thing is what we are wearing. So something comfortable. The feet, please wear shoes that are nice and snugged, so your feet are really nicely supported. Try not to use any shoes that are a little bit loose. So it's something that needs to be nice and supportive for your feet. And use a chair to start with that is nice and sturdy. We don't want a chair that you don't feel supported. Ideally that you have a space at the sides of the chair to do exercises. So yeah, just something that is just nice and supportive, okay? So the first thing that we are going to be doing is sitting on your sitting bones. That means just there in the corner of your bottom, you can come up off the chair a little bit. So if your back is completely at the back of the chair, please come out a little bit so you have a bit more space. And for me, it's like halfway of the chair. So for you, whatever is appropriate, feet on the floor. So it's really, really important that you have the feet on your floor. And we are going to put the hands here in the solar plexus here, just in the center of the torso. Shoulders down. And we are going to put our shoulders up, breathing in and reaching down with the shoulders. Again up and down and a bit more and down. And now really reaching down with the feet on the ground. We are just going to sway. It's like if we are a pendulum, nice and soft. Breathing. That's it, really nice. And we are now going to go forward and back, like if we are in a rocking chair, and back, always with the feet on the ground. Excellent, really nice. And now we are going to do some exercises with the hands. So shoulders down and really make a circle with your hands and your wrists. It looks a little bit like flamenco style movement. You can move your fingers. That's it, a little bit like a fan going in and coming out. If you cannot do that, then that's fine. Just really give a little bit of circularity to the wrist and the other way around. Don't forget to breathe. Shoulders down and upper body nice and up. Kind of really lifting a little bit from the back of your neck. Lovely. Now we are going to put the hands together. And we are going to make circles. This one can be a bit tricky, but just try to make circles with the hands and the other way. It gets easier as we do it more. And now open your fingers and change the position of the fingers. So sometimes we put the index of one hand to top, then change and put the index of the one hand or the other hand on top. So you're changing the way that your hands are interlinked. So you're using both sides of the body in the same way. And make circles. You may notice that it's a bit more difficult on one side than the other. It's always the case. But it's good to work with symmetry. And the other way. Now we are going to, with the hand, we are making a nice fist. And we are punching gently on the palm. Gently, if you have arthritis in your hands, but it's good for stimulating the circulation. So just gently. And then to the other side. Great. And now just really stretch your fingers. Stretch your fingers and just wiggle them. Like if we are, people say like playing a piano. If there are any piano players in there, I apologize because nobody can play a piano like this. But it's just to give us an idea. And really relax. Now we are going to put our hands in fists and drop. Like if you want to get rid of a bit of water, you're flicking water. Use the breathing. And we are going from the base. Going up, and this is a point where we are noticing which side is easier to lift and the other. Just take your arms as high as you can. Don't hurt yourself. Find your point. Chest up. Every time you raise your arms, you need to raise your chest. It goes together. And if you can go all the way up to the top, and now we are coming back through the center. Now we are going the other way. Going up, chest up. And going all the way around and around and around and around. Lovely. And resting there now for a second. It may be quite exhausting, particularly if you're really like flicking your hands. Nice. Hands on the shoulders and making really nice little circles. Whatever direction, because we are going to change it in a minute. So just reaching and going around and around and around. And you can start very small, and then you can make it as big as possible. Reaching out with your chest, squeezing the back. Reaching out with your chest and squeezing the back as the elbows go around. Don't forget to breathe. And around. And now we are going the other way. So squeeze the back and the front. The back and the front. Back and the front. Back and the front. One more. And now I'm going to give you another exercise that you can use to take the movement a little bit further. Have a go. If you cannot do it, that's fine. Just keep building. It's something that, you know, all these exercises, some days may be easier than others. That's how the body goes. So just really try to build on what you've got and really take it as far as you can comfortably take it. So this one is an interesting one. So what we are going to do is trying to put the elbows as close as possible. Some of you might be able to put them together, some of them may not. That's fine. Take it as close as possible. Now, imagine that you are lifting the elbows up, reach up, keep that height, and going around and release. It feels really nice when you get to the maximum point. I'm going to give you my profile. So here we go. We are going here in the center. Use your pelvis. So here's like if you're making a bow with your back. Reach up with your chest. Reach up with your elbows. Keep reaching up. Oh, and it's like a proper yawn. It's a yawn opportunity. Reaching up. And one more. And now the other way. So imagine you're reaching. I'm going to give you my profile so you see it. You go out. Out, 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 out. Elbows together and release the back. And up. Your hands may move around your shoulders. That's fine. Use your chest. Last one. And reach up. And center. Take a minute there. There is no rush. And now what we are going to be doing is a little bit of spirals. So a good way of doing it is if you put one hand in your hip and the other one in the inside of the leg. And imagine that you're reaching from the chest and you're reaching from the hip. So you're going up and then just nudge a little bit this hip and go it in the spiral. Nice and soft, but engaged. So remember all the components. Reaching away with the hand, nudge the hip, chest up, and a spiral. And then through the center, one more each side. Up. It's a little bit like if you're going up a staircase, so keep going up. Keep going up. Last one. Lovely. And now we are going to hold on to our forearm. And imagine you're reaching, you're lifting your chest, and we are going to the side, reaching the side, and going to the other. Reaching, reach, reach. It's like making figure of eights with the torso. And center. Now, change the way that you're holding your forearm. So if one is on the outside, change it around. This one may take a while to actually find the way. It's one of those things with the brain. And just really find the opposite side. And we are reaching up with your chest. And again, spirals. It's a nice soft massage on the lower back. Find your figure of eight. Last one. And center. Now we are going to put the hands together, shoulders down, and imagine that there is a line between the chest and the hands. Yeah, so you're in this position. Now try to create a separation between the hands. So you will feel that your upper body is a little bit more engaged, and your shoulders are down, and your chest is up. And now just go around. And the other side. Important that you are reaching down with your feet. So your knee is not doing this. That kind of thing. Try to reach down with the feet and then your upper body goes around. And now you put your hands out. So then we are working with a slightly different set of muscles. And I'm going to show you one of my favorite exercises. This is very good for the morning. Now, really think about how far up you can take them. This is not a test. You go with what your body has. So we are going from the base, chest up, and take your arms as high as you can. Really reaching. It's like a proper yawn. It's nice stretch. And now we are coming through the center. And now we are taking the hands out, like so. And the chest. It's like if it's jumping over the arms. I'm giving you my profile in a minute so you can see how it looks. Now we change the hands again. The palms are facing up. And we are reaching up. Oh, proper yawn. Open your armpits. Reaching up from the chest. Relax your back. And now the chest goes over your arms. One more. Going up. And chest up. Lovely. And center. Now I'm going to give you a couple of leg exercises, stretches. And then we are going to do an opening and we are going to do some dancing afterwards. So the first one that I'm going to do with the legs is knee circles. Now, it's really important. All of you have different abilities. So I will start with touching the floor, making a circle. Now, try to keep your knee below your hip. If you have a chair that needs to be propped up, please do. And then we are going the other way. Don't forget to breathe. Lovely. Now we try with the other leg. Making nice circles. Touching the floor. And the other way. Sometimes it's more difficult to make a circle in one way or another. That's fine. We are building on ability. Now, here's the test. Hold on to the chair. And this one, you need to use your abdominal. So imagine that you are lifting up from the hip there. And you are making a little bit of a curl. Yeah? So really reaching up. And what we are doing is double knee circles. So really squeeze the legs together. Squeeze the legs together. Support yourself on the chair. And the other way. That's it. Really nice. Excellent. And now we are going to do some stretches. I'm going to give you my profile. So the first one, we are going to put the foot in flex, and the hand is on the thigh of the other leg. Now you're reaching up and you're going forward. You will feel the stretch in the hamstrings really clearly. Swap. Coming up. Now we are doing it with the foot on the floor. Sometimes it's really difficult to put the foot down. You may be here. That's fine. Just try to build on up to the point that your foot is on the ground. And change. And change. So you can repeat these more times. Let's do it one more. With flex and then point. Flex. Flex. Point. And point. And now the last one that we are going to be doing is full leg circles. Here, you can hold onto your chair. And the idea is that you are massaging the joint. So you take the leg as further around as you can. You can touch the floor or not. Another thing that you could do is put the foot in flex and point when you come through the center. Flex, point. Flex, point, and center. Let's try the other leg. Flex, point. Don't forget to breathe. And now we are doing the other way around, always symmetrical. So we go out and through the center. So take it wherever you can. Your opening may be here. That's fine. And out and center the other leg. Great. And this one is just the best. So you're really opening your legs, nicely supported on the chest and the chair, reaching up. Oh, bigger stretch. You can open your mouth, you can open your eyes, you can open everything really nice and open. And bring it to the center. Once more, start with the feet. Really position yourself. You're supporting yourself with the chair, but also with the chest. It's a balancing exercise as well as a stretch. Reaching. And third time lucky. Here we go. Opening up the legs. Open. Open your mouth and your eyes. And center, how are you feeling? I hope that you're feeling opener, you're feeling a little bit more with something that is happening inside. We are going to be doing some dancing now. I've got some props. You don't need to do it with props, but it's a little bit more colorful. And if not, you can just use whatever you've got in the house that is similar. You could do it on the chair, or you could do it standing up. In some cases, I'm going to be doing it in both ways. So, whatever you feel that you want to do, that you feel comfortable with, just go for it. So let's just put the music in here. And as usual, I try to do a combination of different dance styles and different things. So the first one, I'm going to use my pompons. And we are going to be doing a little bit of salsa.
Comenzó la fiesta.
Circles with the wrist.
A mí me gusta quemarme con tu calor. No hay duda de que tú estás dura y sí que tienes sabores. Tu cuerpo es como una escultura y me fascina tu olor. Tu piel tiene una gran textura bronceada por el sol.
Me quemas. Y el fuego en mis penas me pone a bailar.
Maracas, and
soñando con ser el dueño de tu cintura. Fuego me está quemando, que suba la temperatura.
Using the legs, and
con tu cuero, me quemas poco a poco, que esto no
us instead. Excellent, fantastic. Okay, so I'm going to put this away. The next track that I have, get a bit of water if you need now, and you can make a pause or something. This one is, we are going to be doing freestyling. So whatever you want to do, either in the chair or standing up, is up to you. I'm going to do a standing up this time. So yeah, enjoy. Here we go.
Okay, you want another, you get it. And you're going to meet the winners of the Harvest Moon Contest, Jimmy and Javeda dancing to Little Richard and Tutti Frutti.
Ready, you say. Rock, bang, boom, bang, rock, bang, bang, tutti, frutti.
To the booty, oh, to the booty, oh, to the booty.
Well done. Excellent. Take a breather. Now it's time to take a breather. I'm going to grab another prop as well. I've got, again, get some water. You can make a pause now. We are going to be doing one more and then the cool down. And this one, again, if you want to do a sitting down or a standing up, I'm going to be sitting down now. It's a good breather for me too. And here we go. And we are just going to be doing the final stretch. And this style of music is very, very different. And I hope you enjoy it as well. Breathing. Here we go. Nice and soft. Meridian of the heart, follow the arm. Thank you. on the leg. Come down. To one side. Circular movement and the other side. And center. Now we are putting our hands together, reaching up like if you're swimming upwards. Keep that height. And again, you may want to stretch your legs as well. And now we are going to do the opposite. So we gather from the back, bring your legs together and reaching from the back. And last one. And thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed that. As I said, this is for you. So if you want to pause it, get a glass of water, have a breather and join back, watch it as many times as you want, progress a little and take care of yourself. Don't do anything that hurts you. This is for you to become stronger, more flexible. So really listen to your body. Just push a little bit out of your comfort zone, but don't go too much beyond to the point that you feel uncomfortable. So enjoy and be healthy, be well, and see you next time.